Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. In this video, I'll talk about carpal tunnel syndrome and my technique of ultrasound-guided release of transverse carpal ligament. I'd appreciate it if you could turn on English caption for better communication. Before the main course, I'll review the carpal tunnel syndrome first. Carpal tunnel comprised of bony duct-like structure consisting of carpal bone and the roof of which is the fibrous but rigid transverse carpal ligament. Let's close look at the carpal bones. Scaphoid, trapezium, pisiform, and hamate. They give attachment to the transverse carpal ligament and form bilateral borders. Purple rings. This schematic drawing shows the ligament structures and attachment sites. Several anatomic layers have been described, and it can be divided into superficial and deeper layers. Carpal tunnel is made of 9 flexor tendons and median nerve. Median nerve enters the tunnel in the midline or slightly radial to the tendon. Steroid injection is most commonly used interventional procedure, but its effect is suspicious. According to Cochrane's review, local corticosteroid injection for carpal tunnel syndrome provide greater clinical improvement in symptoms at only 1 month after injection. Significant symptom relief beyond 1 month has not been demonstrated. Let's talk about surgical treatment. Surgery for carpal tunnel syndrome provides carpal tunnel release in which transverse carpal ligament is cut to create more space in the carpal tunnel and reduce the pressure. Long-term beneficial outcomes following carpal tunnel release are seen in approximately 70 to 90% of the patients. Surgical treatment is the golden standard of the treatment, but I believe that surgical release should be provided after other non-surgical treatment fail. I have developed and used ultrasound-guided transverse carpal ligament release technique for a long time. I believe it is a simple, safe, and effective technique using cheap needle as powerful as surgical release and expensive ultrasound surgery. I use oblique transverse approach from radial side, targeting superficial layer using standard 18 gauge needle. These questions are possible critics against my procedure. I am trimming the superficial layer of transverse carpal ligament because it is safe. Incomplete cut of the transverse carpal ligament can worsen the symptom because remained ligament can tether the median nerve. It is stressful in the primary pain clinic. Let's go to the clinical practice. Let the patient's hand palm up position. Support the wrist on the back with a towel to extend the wrist. I infiltrate local anesthetic to the superficial area of transverse carpal ligament and subcutaneous tissue. I keep an eye on the superficial volar artery, ulnar artery, and palmar cutaneous branch of median nerve. Please watch the direction of median nerve from the schematic drawing. Small arrows indicate the pisiform and hook of hamate, and red circles indicate the needle entry point. The needle moves obliquely toward the pisiform and hamate. The ulnar artery is on the far side, and the superficial volar artery is in the near side. Let me explain more structure that we should needle penetrate the ligament, latching the needle tip under the ligament. median nerve is tightly attached to the transverse carpal ligament, so I'm extremely cautious when penetrating the ligament and preparing abrupt loss of resistance. Hydrodissection between the transverse carpal ligament and median nerve would provide a safe margin for the transligament release. Observe fluid in between median nerve and overlying ligament structures. I assemble the bevel tip needle with a 5 ml Luolax syringe. I will use it as a small blade release, but much effective than local steroid injection or hydrodissection technique. Thank you for watching. If you like it, please subscribe to it. See you again.